Today I want to share how to make an autoimmune paleo or AIP diet friendly sweet potato breakfast bowl. It's the time of year when people start to crave warming breakfast bowls and porridges like oatmeal and grits and all of these cream of wheats and things that really warm you up inside and make you feel like it's not so crazy cold outside. Unfortunately, on an AIP diet, all of the grain-based ones are out, and even some of the ones that you would have on a typical paleo-style diet, like a nut-based kind of porridge, is out as well. However, there are still many different kinds of porridges you can have on AIP. Some people make it out of cauliflower. You can also do things like spaghetti squash. But the one I particularly love the most is a sweet potato bowl. It looks like this, and it's just basically mashed potatoes, but done in a different way, and with some ingredients that make it a little bit more nourishing for the morning time, so you're not gonna have a blood sugar spike in the morning, but also you're gonna get some protein and some fat as well. It doesn't matter what kind of sweet potato you use. You can use a white sweet potato or just the regular red inside ones or like the purple sweet potatoes. Doesn't matter as long as it's a sweet potato, because white potatoes are nightshades and not compliant on AIP, but sweet potatoes are compliant. I use the Instant Pot to cook my potato, but you can use a variety of different methods. With the Instant Pot, you're going to put the little rack insert into the Instant Pot liner. Add a cup of water and then set it to about 22 minutes, depending on how big your sweet potato is. I was using a fairly large one that was split in half so it could fit inside of the Instant Pot, and I did that for 22 minutes. If you have a really teeny tiny one, you can go down to like 18 minutes. And if it's even bigger and like you're able to fit it all in without cutting it, you may want to go up a little higher to like 24 minutes or so. You can also peel and then dice the sweet potato and boil it for about 15 minutes. You can steam it, or you can roast it in the oven for about an hour at like 425. Whatever method you want to do is fine. However you typically make mashed sweet potatoes, it's perfectly fine as long as they get soft. And then once they are done cooking, you're going to remove the peel if you haven't already, put it into a bowl, and then I like to add one scoop of collagen. Now, collagen is like gelatin, but it's the one that does not have to be heated. I personally like to use the one from Perfect Supplements. That's my favorite brand, but I know Vital Proteins also makes one, and Great Lakes does as well. If you do the Great Lakes one, it's the one in the green can, not the red can. And then after I add the collagen, which is a good boost of protein and also helps things like your skin and your hair and your nails, as well as your gut lining, I also add about a tablespoon or so of coconut oil for some fat. You could also do coconut butter if you like. And if you like it a little bit runnier, you could add coconut milk as well to give a little bit of fat and just make it a little bit looser. I also like to add about a teaspoon or so of cinnamon. You can definitely increase it or decrease it or even omit it if you don't like the taste of cinnamon. And then you can optionally put in a pinch of salt if you'd like as well. And then I use the immersion blender to just mix it all up in the bowl, but you could use a potato masher and mash it by hand, or a mixer. Any method that you typically make mashed potatoes works perfectly fine as well. You just want to get it into like a mashed potato kind of consistency, and then you serve it into your serving bowls. And if you're gonna save it for later, put it into your like to-go serving bowls. And then I like to add the toppings. And the toppings where it gets fun. On this particular bowl, I put some sliced fresh figs and some sliced tiger nuts. But the toppings are kind of endless. Even on AIP, there are so many different things that you can put on it that really changes up the flavor of the dish. Whether you want it savory or sweet or spicy or not, I mean, it's just however you wanna do it. The world is your oyster when it comes to toppings. In my upcoming membership site, The Autoimmune Collective, I am going to provide a huge list of toppings that you can do for breakfast bowls, for both sweet potato bowls and other different kind of bowls that I will be giving the recipes for within that membership. So make sure that you sign up below to get on the early bird list for that, because that will give you early bird entry and pricing within the next few weeks. These bowls really are good for traveling too. I like to take them if I have to go somewhere. I'll just put them in a large Tupperware and then just take them with me and then dole out a little bit per day. heat it up in their microwave or on the stove, or they're even good cold. And they are just a great option to take with you. You can take some toppings and pre-slice them and then have them in a little other containers and then just put them on top. And then you have your breakfast in the morning without a lot of hassle and not having to think about it. They also make good batch cooking kind of things. So you just put a whole bunch of potatoes into however you're gonna cook it, and then just have like a couple of these bowls throughout the week. And it really does fill that need that you have for a warming porridge in the morning, especially during these cold winter months. And if you make this, let us know in the comments below. Like, let us know what kind of toppings you put on it, because it's always fun to see what other people do and to get ideas. Other than that, I'm going to be going ahead and doing videos only once a week for the time being, just so I can get everything all set up in the Autoimmune Collective, so I can launch it and have all of this great information for you within there. So it's just gonna be, I think, Tuesdays for the next few weeks, and we'll see how it goes from there. Otherwise, I will see you next Tuesday.